Lord Leonard Cohen released Hallelujah. Composed the song and released it on December 11, 1984. First charted on December 27, 2008. So it's a decade, more than a decade. But it sells in millions, airplay and streaming in millions also. It was revived by Jeff Buckley, released on August 23, 1994. First charted on December 20, 2008. So it is also a quite long period. And Hallelujah was also revived by Alexandra Burke. Was released on December 17, 2008. First charted on December 27, 2008. Same thing happened, sales in millions and airplane streaming millions. Macklin Gladwell does a podcast on, as he says, what happens when genius takes sweet time with nurse. He mentions economist David Galinson's theory of creativity with David's art into conceptual innovation. Mind the artist who work quietly and have a determined or immediate impact and experimental innovation, in which artists don't necessarily know what they're trying to say right away, and their influence takes time. Gladwell holds up Leonard Cohen's Hallelujah, a song about love that has soared and gone stale, as a quintessential example of experimental innovation that critic Alan Light wrote an entire book about song, and said Cohen wrote 50 to 70 verses for the song, working in for 5 years. Finally emerged on his 1984 album, Various Positions, Secret Chord, and was released in Spain and the Netherlands as a single. Really care for music, but it barely makes a record. If you go back to listen to that first Hallelujah, the song's failure makes sense. It's not there yet. Composing Michael Barker composed the original version. So hyper serious. That's its outmost sometime. Hallelujah. Cohen continued working the song live in that game, known from the Velvet Underground. Your faith was strong, saw him perform and requested the lyrics. Cohen responded with 15 tracks beats. Hale recorded it for the 1991 Leonard Cohen tribute album.
And she broke your and throne, your and she cut and your hair, and from Drugs your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, we have confession. Blues. Lyrics. Like I used to be allowed. For I knew you. All I ever learned from love was how to shut up.
Now, maybe there's a God alone. As for me,
going on to be performed,
all I ever learned from love is how to shoot at someone who outdrew you. But it's not a cry.
It's Gail's version that Jeff Buckley aired and signs to record. Gladwell called it as Definitive One, a cover of Dan Gale's cover, only with Gale's piano swapped out.
This is a song by Leonard Cohen.
He said,
I've heard there was a secret chord that David plays and he's the Lord. But you don't really care for music
covers of Buckley covering Gale, covering his wife.
Minor fall, a major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah.
In Borres, his only studio album, before his death in 1987.
Hallelujah.
An album achieved gold status in the US in 2000. But the song
faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, a beauty and the moonlight.
Reaching number 7 in Norway.
She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the
Buckley in Sweden. In March of 2008, it topped the Billboard Digital Song Chart after Jason Castro performed the song on American Idol.
Baby, I've been here before.
In 2007,
I know this room, I've walked this floor. I used to live
in the National Observer named Buckley's version the greatest song of
seeing your flag on the marble arch, and love is not a victory march. It's golden, it's a
golden song that
it
can joyous or bittersweet with it on one
heart. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The songs on Face Again in 2001 Ben's Freak Rocco's What Wine Right recorded a song as a tribute to Buckley. It was used to a soundtrack and reached number 97 on the UK chart. However, it was Gale's version which was actually used in the film. There were also successful chart versions of Edie Lang, Justin Timberlake, Alexander Bird. Long first recorded Hallelujah in 2004. But it was her 2010 version performed at the Vancouver Winter Olympics. In 2010, which gave chart success, reaching number 2 in Canada. That same year, Judith Timberlake and Justin Timberlake reached number 13 on the U.S. charts with his duet version with Matt Morris.
The baffled king composing Hallelujah.
Alexander Bird won the fifth series television talent competition, X Factor in England, and recording of Hallelujah became the top writing a selling song of 2008, reaching number 1 in the UK and selling more than a million copies. Set a European record most singles sold in 24 hours. Kitchen chair. Bach's version was even a major boost as a result. Reached number 2 in the UK behind Bach's version and number 1 in France. Sources of this information was taken from the IMDb Encyclopedia in favor of Alexander Bird.
It goes like this, the fourth,
Revolutionist
the fifth,
History Podcast, July 2016. Hallelujah by Malcolm Gladwell.
Hallelujah.
Also, taken from Songfacts and last but not least, the Wikipedia.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight all around. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the Hallelujah. 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 Thank you.
Cohen's record that they've been played and it pleased the Lord. But do you really care for music? Do you? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lead, the baffled king composing. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Over to ya, and she tied to you to the kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah, hallelujah.